Hi, Cancer. Welcome to September. This is Teresa from TarotByT.com, and I want to thank you for subscribing and liking my channel. And before we start with your reading, I want to bring in some good energy. Let's ring these bells. And thank you for your wonderful comments and your support. I really enjoy reading all the comments, and I'm really glad when I hear that some of the readings have been helping people and people have been resonating with the readings. That's great, great news. So, Cancer, let's see what's going on in your life for September. And I don't know why this candle keeps going out, but okay. What does Cancer need to know about love and life in September? September's going to be kind of a crazy month with Mercury retrograde and two eclipses. So we'll see what goes on in September. I think the dust is going to be shaken up in September for most people. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes we need to have the dust shaken up. Okay, what does Cancer need to know for the month of September about love and life? What does Cancer need to know about the month of September coming up? May only the highest forces be present at this reading to ensure that the truth be told. Nine of Pentacles, King of Wands, Six of Pentacles, Two of Swords, Nine of Cups, this is good, Ten of Wands, the King of Swords, Two of Pentacles, the Nine of Swords, and the World. Okay, Cancer. Let's see what's going on with you. So the Nine of Pentacles. The Nine in your present, you might be working at a job where you have pretty much a lot of freedom, or the freedom to do the job without a lot of supervision. Either that, or this is sometimes the card of the entrepreneur, where you're thinking about starting your own business. In any case, you want to do your own thing. You want to be your own boss. You don't want to have to answer to someone. So whether you're in your own business or whether you're working in a situation where you're the manager and you don't require supervision, you're doing okay financially, because the Nine of Pentacles is the person who is enjoying the material. You know, she's in her home, she's surrounded by her material things, but she's a little bit lonely and she would like to share her life with someone. And so this King of Wands could be the person that you're concerned with in a romantic situation. So the King could be someone that you either work with. You might even work with him, because the King is usually a good leader, and he could be also a mentor. So it could be someone who's giving you advice. Like if you're thinking about starting a business, this King can help you with advice. Or it could also mean that you need to tap into your own leadership ability, and you need to be the King of your life, you know. You need to be the leader. You need to be the more outspoken and more have more presence. But if it's a romantic partner, the King of Wands is someone who's very outgoing, very outspoken, not afraid to speak their mind, likes a lot of attention, kind of like Leo energy, even though the Wands are usually fire signs. Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. And they're very honest. But even if it's not the sign of the person, you know, you could be involved with someone else. But it could be like, you know, they have a fire moon or rising sign and is fire. But they're very honest, and they're not afraid to speak their mind. And they have a big heart. They have a good heart. They're very generous. And they like helping people. they like giving advice. So you could be getting advice from this king. Or this king could be someone who's very supportive of you and whatever you're trying to do in September. In the past, you have the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles sometimes means an imbalance in the giving. So you could be in a relationship where one person is paying all the bills. One person, you know, every time you go out, that either you or the other person is paying, buying the dinner or buying this or buying that. And it could be sometimes it's, you know, like either a person, you're trying to buy someone's love by giving them a lot of gifts or buying them, you know, dinner, or it could be some the other way around, that someone's trying to buy your love. In any case, I think it's more that because you're a Cancer, Cancer has a tendency to be very giving, very nurturing. So you might be over-giving in a relationship where you're not getting enough back in the past. And maybe you're just giving more, or you're giving too much because you're wanting love in return. So you think, well, if I give, you know, he'll appreciate me or she'll appreciate me. So with the Six of Pentacles, you have to find that balance between giving and also giving to yourself. You can't allow people to zap your energy. You can't overgive where then you're just drained and you have no energy left. So you have to take some time out also to recharge. Don't overgive. Remember that, or include yourself in the equation of the giving. Because with sixes, there's always the balance. You see the scales here. And if you're going to give without strings. Don't give conditionally. You have to give and forget about it. Don't expect anything in return. Because otherwise, that can become manipulation, where you're trying to manipulate someone by the giving. So be careful. That's just a warning to be careful about how you give. Give, you know, without the thought of getting. But also make sure that you're not being taken advantage of, that your kindness, you know, because you're a giving person, you could attract people that are takers. So just find that balance between the giving and the taking. Make sure you get time to rest and give to yourself so that you can recharge. In the recent past, you had the Two of Swords. So there could be that if you've had a falling out with someone, you're trying to decide what to do, and you're kind of like having a hard time seeing the facts. There are things going on that you just can't see. So you feel like you don't know enough information to make a decision about this relationship. And so you're on the fence. The Two of Swords person is, they're afraid to act. So they're procrastinating making a decision. They're saying, well, I don't know if I really want to do this. They're afraid to move. So they're just sitting there thinking and contemplating and weighing the pros and cons. Really, it could also be a standoff between the other person. So maybe if you've had a falling out with someone, neither one of you wants to make the first move. They're waiting for the other person to make the move. So if you want to get out of that, you have to take a step. But I think that if you're dealing with a fire sign, they will probably make the first move because fire signs have less patience. And Cancer is afraid of rejection. So a Cancer person will probably wait for the other person to make the move. But so it looks like, though, in the future, you have the Nine of Cups. But in any case, and so that means that you have the potential to get what you want in this situation. That's the Wish Fulfillment card. So if you've been carrying a heavy burden and really worried about a situation, a relationship, you're going to be putting that burden down. Because here's the Ten of Wands. That's the end of a cycle. So you can't, if you've been working really hard and you feel like, oh, I've been carrying all this responsibility and I don't know if I can go on, you're coming to the end of the road with that. So you're going to be able to, maybe you've been working two jobs or juggling too many things. So you're going to be able to put that down because something good is going to happen in a relationship, something that you're going to get what you want. That's a wish fulfillment card. And sometimes with the two, I want to also say, you need to drop your guard and be honest in the relationship and tell the person how you really feel. So if you're holding anything back, that's only going to separate you. I think you need to, you know, let your guard down a little bit and let that person know what you're feeling. And that will help you solve whatever problems. Here on the staff, you have the King of Swords. So you're trying to make a decision based on your intellect rather than your heart or emotions. Maybe you're being a little bit too harsh, because the King of Swords can have harsh, can be like a tough, harsh energy, or maybe that's someone you're dealing with. You feel like they're a little bit too standoffish or too unapproachable. Maybe you're afraid to approach them. They're kind of intimidating. But in any case, they are fair. So if you're dealing with someone, now this could be someone who's an air sign, which would be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And they're not as emotional as, you know, like Cancer is a water sign. Water signs are very emotional. They make their decisions based on emotion. This person makes their decisions based on fact. You know, just the facts, ma'am. I don't care about, you know, sometimes they appear like they have no compassion. But really, they're just scientific. It's just the way they think is different. They're ruled by their mind and their thoughts and facts. They want to see the facts. They don't really care about, you know, the emotions around the situation. So you might be feeling that this person is a little bit harsh and judgmental. And you may not really understand where they're coming from. But they will be fair. Whatever decision they do make will be fair. Now, this can also represent you're worried about some kind of legal situation. Because sometimes the swords, the King of Swords, can represent law or some kind of legal thing that's coming up. And you might be worried about it because you have the Nine of Swords here. And that's someone sitting up at night worried, your mind's racing. You're not sure how it's going to go, how it's going to turn out. Maybe you feel like you've been through a difficult situation. And you're just tired of carrying the burden. You want to put it down. And you will, because you have the Nine of Cups and the World at the end. So it's all going to work out fine in the end. A lot of your mental stress is really all in your mind. You're worrying. You know, that's a Cancer thing. Cancers worry a lot. You tend to overthink things or over-worry. And everything is really fine. But you're like, oh, what if this happens? Or what if that happens? You know, you're waiting for the other shoe to drop. You have this, now, if you're dealing with a relationship, you have the Two of Pentacles in the environment situation. So you could be involved with either that you might be dating two people, or you might be dating someone who is juggling two situations, because that could also be someone working two jobs too. You know, maybe you've got a lot of irons in the fire. You might be working one job while you're planning to develop your own business. So you might be having like, I'm working my day job, but then I'm trying to develop this business on the side. So you're really like stressed out too. And you're dealing with a lot of, and with this, with the King of Swords, you could be dealing with, you know, legalities, paperwork. And you're kind of stressed out about it because you feel like you're overworked and overburdened. But you're coming to the end of, you're not going to be doing this forever. Eventually, you're going to be putting down one of the things and you're going to be choosing. This is also, you know, someone in your life is going to make a choice. So at some point, if you're dating someone, they might be choosing between you and someone else. And you might be a little bit worried about it. But I think in the end, you have the World card. And you have the Nine of Cups. So I think you're going to be the one of that gets chosen. So I wouldn't worry too much. Don't stress yourself out. I think that everything's going to work out in your favor. And if you're working two jobs, eventually you're going to wind up giving up one of them and focusing on the one that you really want. The business. I think you're going to want to do your own thing and be your own boss. And I think it's going to be successful. You have the World here. The World is like the end of a cycle where everything kind of comes together and you're doing work that you love. And wherever, if you take a new job, they just absolutely love you and you feel welcome. So whatever you've experienced in the past where you felt like maybe you felt that you aren't valued or appreciated, in this new situation, you're going to feel like, oh, this is where I should have been all along. Why did I wait so long? You're going to really enjoy this situation, whether it's a career thing or a relationship. If it's a relationship, you're going to be like in bliss. You're going to be like, you know, you're going to be the one, if the person is trying to choose between you and someone else, you're going to be the one that gets chosen. And you're going to have a really good connection with this person. Everything's going to come together in September for you. So don't worry. Here you have this Nine of Swords of worry. You can put down that worry card. It's all in your mind. Your mind is racing. Your mind is thinking overtime. You'll get through it, and you're going to see that whatever this is, this new thing that's coming up, it's going to bring you a lot of happiness. You're going to feel really much more fulfilled. I have a feeling it could be a career thing where you start a business or you work for yourself in some capacity. And you just love the work. And the people love you. And if it's a relationship, it's going to be like, you know, soulmate connection. You just, everything falling into place. And you're just going to have a great time. So don't stress yourself out with worry. Don't make yourself sick. You'll get through it. If there's any kind of legal situation, you'll get out of it. You'll get through it, and it will work out fine. It's going to work out in your favor. So enjoy your month of September, Cancer. And it's a wish fulfillment, wish come true month for you. So someone from the past might even be coming back with Mercury retrograde and all these eclipses. The eclipses are going to shake things up, but for you, you're going to be in a good place by the end of September. You're going to be where you want to be. So good luck for September, and I hope you enjoyed this reading, and I will talk to you in October. Okay, bye now.